Howdy, friends. Steve DePoe here with the Rose Realty team with this week's Real Estate Vlog for North Texas. Today, items homeowners almost always regret. So things that you've either done to your house or purchased for your house or installed that homeowners almost always regret after they've done it. So like, what could they be? So above ground pools, right? So first of all, if your HOA allows above ground pools, usually above ground pools, we only use for one or two seasons. So like in Texas, it'd be like spring and fall, right? And then just like playground equipment, after that first year, maybe two, something like that, the kids kind of get bored of it. They don't use it as often. They go over a friend's house who's got a built-in pool or a bigger pool or a diving board or something like that. And if you don't really maintain it and trim the grass around it and keep it well maintained and keep the rust off and all that kind of stuff, eventually it kind of starts to deteriorate only after 3 or 4 years, and it starts to look like an eyesore, right? The return on investment just isn't there, and then you have to take it down and get rid of it. So think twice before you go out and purchase an above ground pool. Cheap stuff. Okay. I've kind of talked on this topic a little bit in a way when we've talked about doing kitchen remodels or remodels to your home, right? So don't go for the cheap stuff, whether it's a storage shed out back that you need or something in the house. The really kind of low end or kind of cheap kind of stuff will fall apart quickly. Won't maintain its value, will fade quickly. Oftentimes it doesn't fit together, real well. And if it does fit together real well, then eventually it's going to become loose and rickety, and you're just not going to enjoy it. So spend, a little bit of the extra money for more high end stuff. Don't go bananas. But spend a little bit of extra money for the higher end stuff instead of just going for the low cost, cheapo stuff. Now that may be, there's probably a clause in there that says, if you're talking about like storage things for your kids' stuffed animals or something like that, then I'd say don't worry about it as long as it's safe for them. But if you're going for new cabinets in the garage or new cabinets in the laundry room, or furniture or something like that, don't go for the cheap stuff. It deteriorates real quickly, and it doesn't give you a good return on investment. Speaking of furniture, oversized furniture. Okay, so oversized furniture can mean two things. You have a space, you have a family room. Okay, that you can only fit so much into it. Don't overstuff it. Don't overstuff it with like two couches and four chairs, because you won't be able to move around and it'll look like, the infield at the Indy 500. Okay. So don't do that. Also, don't buy this oversized kind of overstuffed kind of furniture, because it may be, number one, it doesn't really have the comfort level that you were expecting. Number one. And number two, again, it kind of deteriorates kind of quickly and gets out of place kind of quickly, and then you have to find a way to get rid of it, and you don't really get the enjoyment and the sort of the return on investment on it. And lastly, major high-end appliances. So we're talking refrigerators and stoves and dishwashers and ovens and that kind of stuff. Hey, like I said a couple minutes ago, spending the extra dollars for a really good, even high-end stove is well worth it. You get your return on investment on that, but don't go for the 12-burner Chef's Deluxe, stove, or the super high-end maximum capacity oven that you could cook a woolly mammoth in. You don't need it, number one. You won't utilize it as often as you expect, number two. And although it may look cool in the wall for now, you won't get your return on investment when you go to sell it. Okay. So yeah, spend the extra money on high-end appliances. Yeah, you know, definitely. But don't go for like the ultra super duper, unless we're talking about you got $1 million plus home or $2 million plus home, then go for it. Okay. But if you've got your, you know, standard average, the rest of the kind of house that all of us have, you know, kind of home, and you're doing some remodeling, don't go bananas. Don't go overboard with these super deluxe high-end appliances, because you know in the long run it's just not going to work out for you, and you're going to be disappointed. Next week we're going to talk about hidden fees when you're buying a home. Good topic, especially for people who haven't bought a home in a while or for first-time home buyers. This is Steve with the Rose Realty Team. I'm out.